members of IITGN as well as ISHM organizers for giving me an opportunity to talk in this conference. I also would like to acknowledge Professor Ramasubramanian, Professor M. Sriram, and Professor M. D. Srinivas, because whatever I am going to talk today is an outcome of collaborative research on Karana Paddhati. The topic that I am planning to talk here is, the title is Mathematical Basis for Vakya System in Karana Paddhati. The work Karana Paddhati is a text in the Kerala school, which is very much a very important text in two sense. One is the Charles Wish, who has mentioned this text. There are Charles Wish has mentioned four seminal works in Kerala School of Astronomy. One of them is Karana Paddhati, other being our Tantra Sangraha of Neelakanta Swamiyaji, Ganita Yukti Bhasha of Jyeshadeva, and Sadratnamala of Shankara Varman. Karana Paddhati is composed by Pudumana Swamiyaji, and the period of composition is around 1532 AD, that's 16th century. And that is the first importance of the Karana, because it is mentioned by Wish. And the second important thing is, it's Karana Paddhati is the etymological derivation for Karana Paddhati is Karana Karane Paddhatihi. Paddhatihi is the process or the mathematical rationale, we could say. Karane is for doing in the sense composing. The second Karana refers to the class of literature, class of astronomical literature. So the Karana Paddhati stands for, or Karana Paddhati gives the rationale, mathematical rationale for composing Karana class of literature. In the sense, it gives mathematical basis for Karana, some of the parameters or the algorithms mentioned in Karana class of literature, which is one of the, we have already, people have talked about Aryabhatiya, people have talked about Siddhanta Shiromani, which comes under the Siddhantic type of literature, and there are other class of literature which is known as Karana type of literature, Karana school, which evolved, okay, Brahmagupta, the Khandakataka of Brahmagupta is Karana type of literature. As far as the computations are concerned, the computational procedures mentioned in the Karana's texts are very simpler compared to the Siddhantic texts. This is based on the simplicity or the complexity we are concerned. We can divide them into Karana and Siddhanta. Then we have two more categories like Tantra and Mahatantra. The other class of literature is Vakya system. So Karana Paddhati not only gives the basis for or the rationale for Karana school of literature, even it gives the mathematical rationale for the Vakya school. So here in this talk, I would be dealing with something known as, the Karana Paddhati essentially gives a mathematical technique known as Valyupasamhara, which is mentioned by Professor M. D. Srinivas, which is analogous to the continued fraction. We can find this technique throughout the text, the Pudumana Swamiyaji uses this technique to solve different astronomical problems pertaining to, for obtaining the algorithms or the parameters pertaining to Karana school as well as Vakya system. In this context, in the Vakya, there is a term called Khanda. So I would be talking about this Khanda and how Khanda is determined using the algorithm given by the Karana Paddhati, and the rationale for Khanda we can obtain using the continued fraction technique. So Khanda, actually we need to talk about the astronomical context in which the Khanda appears. Before that, I would like to talk about the Vakya system and Vakyas. Vakyas literally means the sentences or the phrases in which Vakyas literally means the sentences or the phrases in the context of astronomy. They represent some numbers or the astronomical parameters in which some numbers are encoded in the in those sentences. So this, say for example, we can trace back the vakyas, set of vakyas or vakyas to the time of Vararuchi, because this is the first set of vakyas we can find. I mean, these are known as Chandra vakyas or Girnashrayadi vakyas or Vararuchi vakyas, whose composer is Vararuchi, 4th century AD. And this has something to do with moons or Chandra vakyas. This starts with Girnashrayaha Dhenavashrihi. So it starts with Girnashrayaha, the sentence known as Girnashraya. So we can call it as Girnashrayadi vakyas. And the number encoded in this vakyas are, so for Girnashraya is 00, 12 and 03. Based on the Katapayadi system of numeration, that I am not going to the details of the system, which is alphanumeral system, where the you might have come across this system. So these are 248 in number, and it has something to do with the moon. This 248 is nothing but the, see here you can see a table. I will talk about this table later. Here you can see this number 248, and this is nothing but the anomalistic revolution of the moon. Moon takes 248 days to complete 9 anomalistic revolution. What is anomalistic revolution? Suppose we are here, Earth is at the center and moon is revolving in a circular motion, and this is moon's apogee or the mandocha, where the moon's velocity is minimum. So this apogee is also moving, is in motion. So this, the motion of moon with respect to this apogee, so at this point the longitudinal difference between moon and its apogee is zero. So it happens in every 27.5 days. So if we want to get a number in terms of integral revolution in integers, so we have these numbers. So in which, see, we have 9 anomalistic revolutions in 248 days and with respect to sunrise. So the khanda, I was talking about the khanda which appears in the computation of longitude of moon using the vakya system. The difference between, so the advantage of vakya system is, here you can see that these are the longitudes of moon encoded in these phrases. If you just remember this number of these phrases, you can actually get the, you can by heart the number of, I mean, longitude of the moon from first day to 248 days, starting from the moon's anomaly is zero. Again, when moon's anomaly is zero, the first day is first, that day is considered as the first day, and the longitude of the first day is that Girnashraya, and the 248 day you will have the 9 revolutions, anomalistic revolutions, and you can by heart 248 values easily. So this is Siddhant. So in order to, so this khanda appears in the vakya system. Vakya system, compared to the Siddhantic procedure, involves using basic arithmetical operations, we could find the longitude of planets by memorizing the vakyas, and we should memorize the vakyas, and we should also know some astronomical parameters such as khanda, such as Shodhyadruva, etc. And by using some basic arithmetical operation, we can obtain the planetary longitude for any desired day. So in Siddhantic procedure, this is the Siddhantic procedure for computing the longitude of moon. First, one has to find the mean longitude. So this is, A is Ahargana. Ahargana, Ahaha means days, Gana is group of civil days from the starting of epoch. Usually in the Siddhantic text, the epoch is the starting of Kali, that is February 18, 3102 BC, where it is assumed that the planetary longitudes are zero, planetary positions are zero. By assuming that, one has to find the average positions of the planets for these many number of elapsed days. This is the number of revolutions given in the text and number of civil days in a Mahayuga. And taking the fractional part, you have, and by multiplying 360, you will get the mean longitude of the planet, and applying this eccentricity correction term, you will get the true position. So in the Vakyatic text, so as I mentioned, this Vararuchi Vakyas or Girnashrayadi Vakyas or Chandra Vakyas, we can date back to 4th century, but it just lists the vakyas, and we can decode the numbers from those vakyas. Neither we have the full-fledged vakyas text only during the 13th century, that is 1282 AD. The text is known as Vakyakarana. It is a Karana text which uses the vakyas in order to compute the planetary positions and other astronomical parameters. So all these vakya texts, Sputachandrapti is another vakya text which is essentially used for computing the longitude of moon, that is by Madhava. So this is Vakyakarana. I am considering Vakyakarana, where first it gives the some parameter known as Khanda. So it is Vedhedha Jnana Tushtaha. So the number corresponds to this string, or the phrase, is 1600984, and it also gives something known as Dhruva. Dhruva is nothing but the planetary true longitude of the moon, Senanari Nathanam. This corresponds to this Khanda, and this Nitya Deva Sukhadhinam Yajna Yoga Sunayakam Tanur Vishwa Sukham. These are the Dhruvas corresponds to these numbers, 12, 3, 7, 2, 30, 31, 248, etc. So this is nothing but suppose today is the moon's longitude is, say, true longitude of the moon is zero, then after 12,372 days, the moon's longitude would be this much, 297.8 degrees. Suppose today is moon's longitude is zero, then after 3031 days is this. So these are the moon's longitude, increment in the moon's longitude corresponds to this number of days. This is the Senanari Nathanam is the true longitude of the moon at the end of 1600094th day, starting from the beginning of the Kali. And this is referred to as Khanda in the Vakyakarana text. So now this is the previous table. The first and second slide I have shown this table. You can see these numbers, 3031, 12372, and 8818611, 248, you can see. These numbers appears here. I will talk about this table later. So now, these are the parameters which is given in the Vakya text, and this is the algorithm to true longitude of the moon. So it involves three steps. First step is finding Khanda Shesha. Shesha is the remainder. Khanda is already, it is defined in the text. So remainder using the Khanda. That means, so we have Ahargana. Suppose if we want to find the longitude of a moon for any desired day, we need to find the Ahargana. Ahargana is the number of civil days elapsed from the beginning of the Kali till the date. So say that is A. So because Ahargana I have put it as A, and Khanda it is A dash. So just subtract that. So you will get Khanda Shesha. So Khanda Shesha is nothing but A minus A dash. Just divide it by 12372. You will have a quotient, and you will have remainder. Of course, remainder would be lesser than 12372. Take the remainder, divide it by 301. You will have again Q2 is the quotient and R2 is the remainder. Divide it by 248, you will have Q3 is the quotient and R3 is the remainder. So, and definitely this R3 will be lesser than 248, okay. So now, you have to find the net Dhruva. Net Dhruva can be found, so the D1 is the Dhruva corresponds to that 12372 that has to be multiplied by this 9, because Q1 here, Q1 represents the number of cycles, number of 12372 day cycles. So that into D1 corresponds to the Dhruva. D1 is the Dhruva corresponds to 12372. So this will be the net increase in Dhruva after Q1 cycle of 12372 days. That plus D2 into Q2 plus D3 into Q2. So this would be the total Dhruva that will give you the net increment in the moon's true longitude. This is by assuming that at every 12372 days or 3031 days, moon comes back to its apogee. That is the anomalistic anomaly. Moon's anomaly, longitude of anomaly is zero. Okay, and so you have this R3. the remainder that we have obtained at the final division. So that would be less than 248, and we have to, this is V, R3 corresponds to the Vakya, corresponds to R3, that is to be added to this. Vakya, we have 248 Vakyas, for example, so this is the 248 Vakyas. So for example, I just chosen this date, August 6, 1969. So the Aragana corresponds to this is 1851, this. Khanda, Aspara, Vakyakarana is this. So A minus A dash is this. And first quotient is 20, remainder is this much. Second quotient is 1, remainder is, second remainder is 512. Third quotient is 2, and third remainder is 23. So what one has to do is D0 is the dhruva at the end of the khanda. Then D1 minus, so the whatever arithmetical, so this involves only the basic arithmetical operations, the addition, multiplication, division, and subtraction. And you have the, finally you have R3 is 23. So you have to find the 23rd vakya. 23rd vakya is Goraso Nanusyat. So that corresponds to the longitude 307.3883 degrees. If you add that, you will get the true longitude of the moon for the desired date. Now here the khanda plays an important role. So because the first step in the vakya system is to find the khanda shesha, that is subtract the khanda from the ahargana. So this is the khanda. So this is the epoch, that is the Kali epoch, and we have this khanda here. This is desired date. This is ahargana. This is khanda. So what we are doing is ahargana minus khanda, and we are actually from this khanda we are finding the longitude corresponds to the desired day. So the khanda, as I told, this is the day at which moon meets at its apogee, or the conjunction of moon and its apogee happens at the sunrise. Okay, so yeah. So khanda has to satisfy two conditions, because khanda has to satisfy that it should be the moon's anomaly should be zero at the sunrise, and it should also be closer to the ahargana, because then the computation becomes very simpler. So that's because the vakya system is it's making a simpler computation. So the term khanda literally means the section. So we can conclude that khanda literally means the section, segment, or the part. When used in the context of finding longitudes of the planet using the vakya method, it refers to a part of ahargana that needs to be subtracted from full ahargana in order to obtain a certain quantity known as khanda shesha. Is the choice arbitrary? No. A khanda represents the closest epoch, that's your answer to your question, epoch to the ahargana in the recent past, on which mandakendra, or the equation of center, is zero. If the anomaly, longitude of anomaly, is zero, then mandakendra is obviously zero, sign zero. Which one? See, 160084. That's May, is June, or 1282. Yeah, the year is 1282. So now, so we have this 248, 3031, 12, 372, etc. So this is obtained from this. This is the anomalistic revolution. The moon takes anomalistic revolution, these many number of revolutions in these many number of days. This is based on the modified Aryabhatta parameter, based on the correction mentioned in the Haridatta's Shakabda Samskara, which is actually Karana Paddhati, talks about something known as Shakabda Samskara. So using Shakabda Samskara, we can correct the Aryabhatta parameters, this corrected Aryabhatta parameters, where this refers to the number of anomalistic revolutions in a Mahayuga, and these are the number of civil days which anomalistic revolutions happen. Okay, so now how do we obtain this? These are essentially the convergence of these two ratios. These ratios are the convergence, successive convergence of this ratio. So Karana Paddhati gives something known as Valyupasamhara, which is analogous to the continued fraction, from which we can obtain the successive convergence. So this is how, the in second chapter, this is the verse. It goes goes like anyonyahrita bhajiharaka phalam sarvam tvadhodhonyaset ekatradya phalena heenam aparatraikam dvayoschopari kuriyat valyupasamhritim hyuparityah purvapranasham vina tyajyam tat prathamordhvagam haraguna shishtascha vasvechaya. So this is the meaning of this. So I'll just explain the procedure. So if suppose if we have we have a ratio g by h, g is that's what we have chosen. G is gunakara, that is multiplier, and h is haraka or the divisor. So because we have g by h, so we have this is q1 is the quotient and r1 is remainder. And so you have, if you successively mutually if you do the mutual divisions, you have q2, q3, etc. are the quotients. Then what one has to do is the second, so the first step is you have to just list those quotients one below the other and put one above q1. Then second step is put that one there itself and q1 also, just repeat that, and on the same row of q2 multiply this q1 into q2 plus 1, so q1 into q2 plus 1, then q3, etc. And in the third step you have one q1, q1 into q2 plus 1, this one, and multiply this part, this q1 into q2 plus 1 by q3 and add q1. Okay, so finally we have at the nth step we have 1 q1, q1 into q2 plus 1, q1 into q2 plus 1 into q3, and hn equals hn minus 1 qn plus hn minus 2, and cross the 1, delete the 1. Okay, by this you can find the nth convergence, nth divisor. Similarly you can find the nth multiplier by doing the same procedure, but you should not delete one while finding the multiplier. So this is the nth multiplier. By doing this you can find the successive convergence for this ratio. This is the actual revolution of anomalistic revolutions in this number of days. Suppose moon starts its revolution at the sunrise, suppose moon's anomaly is zero for today's sunrise, after these many number of revolutions and after these many number of days, moon again comes back to its apogee, that means anomaly is zero at the sunrise. Only after these many number of days we'll have the exact conjunction between the moon, its apogee and the sunrise. So these are all approximations. So even though we'll get 9 by 248 is another, so we'll have after 9 anomalistic revolutions and after 248 days we'll have moon's conjunction near to the sun, but there will be a finite time difference between the instant of sunrise and the instant of conjunction between moon and its apogee. Okay, so this is the khanda. So how to find or obtain khanda? So this is the mathematical algorithm given by Karna Paddhati is like this. So first, Devendra Sharmaikya Dinendu Tunga Bhedardha Yukteshtu Dinendu Kendrat Itti Kritat Kendra Hareshva Bhishtena Hatya Nanarthi Parairavaptaha Abhishta Harordva Harena Hatva Purvodita Abhishta Harena Hatva Tatra Adhikonam Dyuganat Vishodhyam Harauja Yugmatva Vashatkamena Shishtam Shashankodita Vakya Khandaha. So Vakya Khanda, it gives the algorithm to find the Khanda. Okay, so first one has to find the longitude of anomaly at the, suppose we have a Hargana and we need to find the Khanda. First find the longitude of anomaly with respect to that Hargana in minutes, convert them in minutes, then find this quantity, this is a constant, and multiply that with hi. Hi is, you can choose any one of this, this is hi, any one of these values, this is gi, this is hi. Okay, hi, take the quotient or the integer part of that, multiply with the urdhva harena hi minus 1, then divide it by hi again, then take the remainder and subtract, so this ri is the remainder obtained from this, subtract that remainder from ahargana if hi is odd, if I is odd, for odd hi means for odd I. If it is even, hi minus ri has to be subtracted from A. So odd and even means this is odd, this is even, this is odd, this is even, and so on. Yeah. Now, how do we find, this is the algorithm given, how do we find the, what is the rationale for this algorithm? So this is expressing the anomaly in revolutions, this is in minutes, right? So if you want to represent them in revolutions, divide it by 21,600, 60 into 360. That can be represented as n dash by hi, and integer part of this is n. So the n by hi, n dash by hi is, may not be an integer, but n is an integer. So thus we are essentially approximating the anomaly at A by n by hi, where n is an integer. For large hi, say 12372, this is a good approximation. The Khanda k corresponds to the day when the anomaly is close to zero. Let ki is a minus x. Instead of ri, I am just choosing an arbitrary variable, that is x. So x is the number of days in which Kendra increases by n by hi revolutions. Okay. Now, from this we can have an equation like gi by hi into x minus y equals n by hi, because as the daily motion of anomaly is approximately given by gi by hi, because gi by hi's are basically the rate of daily motion, daily motion of anomaly, where y is the number of completed revolutions. So if you subtract, this is daily motion, subtracted by y means this, we'll get the fractional part. So completed number of revolution of the Kendra is nothing but the anomaly. The above equation can be rewritten as gi xi minus hi y equals n, where we have to solve for x and y in integers. Okay. The solution of this is related to the solution of the equation gi x dash minus hi y dash equals 1. And now the relation between successive convergent in continued fraction. So we have modern continued fraction, where this is a pretty proved identity in the continued fraction. So gi hi minus 1 minus hi gi minus 1 equals minus 1 all raised to I plus 1. So there is a solution of gi x dash minus hi y dash 1 equals 1 for odd I. If I is odd, say 1 is an odd number, so minus 1 all raised square, so we have gi x dash minus hi y dash equals 1, right? So x dash would be, and we can compare this with the previous equation, so we have the solution x dash equals hi minus 1 for odd i's. What about for even i's? If we have I equals even, so in this, if you put even number, say 2, we have minus 1 all raised to 3, that is minus 1. So we have, okay, so I'll just show that. So I have not written. So if we have I equals 2, that is minus 1 all raised to 3, then we have gi hi minus 1. Hi gi minus 1 equals minus 1, or we can rewrite it as hi gi minus 1 minus gi hi minus 1 equals 1. We can add plus and plus gi hi minus 1 and hi gi minus hi gi. So we'll get a solution like x dash equals hi minus hi 1. This is just simple arithmetic. So using that, we can get a solution x dash equals hi minus 1 for even i's. So this is for this. The solution holds for this, but we need the solution for this particular equation gi x minus hi y equals n. So that is x. The solution for x is n hi minus 1, and for odd I, and x equals n hi minus 1 for even I. Okay. So now the general solution for x may be obtained by adding an arbitrary integral multiple of hi. Therefore, the smallest solution for x can be obtained by dividing the above solution by hi and taking the remainder. Therefore, we have the solution x equals remainder of nhi minus 1 by hi for odd i's and hi minus remainder of nhi minus 1 by hi for even I. From this khanda, so this is x is nothing but the days in that khanda shesha, that is a minus a dash. By subtracting this x from a, we'll get khanda. We can fix the khanda. So a minus n, so for odd I, for even I, a minus hi minus nhi minus 1 by hi for remainder. And we have already, we know that x is n is nothing but the for, because we have defined the subtracting factor as r, ri, remainder. So ri could be written as remainder of theta 0 minus theta m a by 2160 hi minus. This is the result that is stated in the text. And we have analyzed this and we found that we have chosen an arbitrary ahargana. We found the khanda corresponds to the corresponding to that ahargana, and we checked whether the anomaly is zero or not. Yeah, surprisingly, it is not exactly zero, but it's say 1.47 minutes, around 1.47 minutes, which is quite accurate, because that error is due to, because as I told, we are anyway taking the successive approximations where there is a finite difference between the instant of sunrise and the instant of conjunction of moon and its apogee. Thank you.